Hey everyone, Rodney here at Klebs Tech, and today I'm going to compare the Juggernaut version 8 and 9 checkpoints. I've gotten many questions lately asking about them, which one is better, why am I using 8, why am I not using this one? And it really comes down to the fact that just because a number is higher with these doesn't always mean that it's going to be better. Often all these checkpoints will work a little bit differently, and your results when going from a lower version to a higher one, the prompts that you're accustomed getting certain results, you may not get those results anymore. So a lot of people end up tending to stay with the previous one they're used to. Now, for example, version 9 was trained using RAM Nvidia photo model and may be better with photographic images. And the creator of Juggernaut mentioned that it was the biggest change. But I decided to run a bunch of different prompts through both of them, the same settings to compare the results, see if either one seems better at certain things. If you don't know where to get the checkpoints, I do have a video that covers that for Fooocus. The Civit AI website is usually where I get most of mine. Now you do want to pay attention at the top. They will have the version numbers up here. So this one is the version 9. We have version 8. You can go back. They also do have a lightning version, which I'm not going to be covering. And once you select which one you want to download, you just click on the download button, download that full model. And once you do that, you want to put it into your checkpoint folder, which if you're just using the default on Fooocus, it will be in your Fooocus folder, models, and then checkpoints. If you download it while Fooocus is running, you do want to hit refresh all files, and then you can choose it in the dropdown. Before I start going over the pictures, I do want to thank David for buying me multiple coffees recently and providing me with some great information and ideas. I do appreciate that. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on each image, so feel free to pause the video if you want to compare them longer. Do note that most of these I ran without Fooocus V2 or any styles or anything, just the prompt. I want to see how they perform by themselves. The images on the left are from version 8. The ones on the right are for version 9. Now I did notice some of the images came out very similar on the same seed. So I think that has to do with, since they're both trained similarly, you actually will get similar images. So this is our first one here. This is without V2, Fooocus V2 or anything. This is one of the examples they used. And I do definitely think the one on the right looks better. And the same with this one, same idea. The one on the right looks like it has more information in the prompt than the one on the left. And that's what they're talking about. They said that was one of the improvements. Now, the next two are actually the same images, but with Fooocus V2, because I wanted to see how these would differ. It definitely makes a difference. I think it does, you know, it does improve upon those. But I think at this point, when you get the Fooocus V2 enabled, I think Juggernaut XL8 looks almost as good as 9. So in this one, we have the rest of these were all Fooocus V2 disabled, no styles, all just the prompt that I put in there that's on the screen. I think these are pretty similar. I'm not sure if there's any difference between the two. Same with our floating islands. I'm not sure if I could say even one of these is better than the other. Now for our watercolor painting of our hobbit hole, these almost came out identically. And if I had to decide, I'd say they pretty much both look the same. As far as which one's better, I don't think there's either one is better. Now on this one, I don't know. I'd say version 9 looks better, but then again, it's one image compared to another. I didn't cherry pick any of these images. They were all the same seed. Now this one, similar, it's a photographic one. All honesty, I don't know. This one's hard to say as well. I do think version 9 might look better in some regards, and version 8 definitely looks better. I think version 9, we get the mist down at the bottom, where in this one, we don't. Now, as far as our die cut sticker example, I think they both did pretty well here. Obviously, if I were to pick one, I'd go with 8 because I just think it looks better. It doesn't have the extra ears and things like that, but I don't know if that's I think for the overall feel of how it generated them, they're pretty similar. On this one, same idea. I don't really think one's better than the other. If I had to, if I had to make a decision, I'd go with the one on the right, but I do like the fact that the one on the left is actually coming out of the mirror. That's a tough one. The one on the right is really not crawling out. You can't tell. On this one, fan of the version 8 result. I think it did a little bit better than that. As far as our portrait of the stormtrooper with his beautiful wife on their wedding day, they definitely handled it differently, the tones and everything. Are different between both images. I'm not sure I think one is worse than the other though. Actually, I think the one on the left I like better. And our color splash wide photo of blue phone booth. Now, same idea. This was similar to the waterfall one. This got more of the fog or mist, and I don't know if that's a result of the image or if it's just because that one's just hazier, you know. Then I'm not sure. In all honesty, I like the Juggernaut 8 result myself better on this version. For this one, I actually think the 9 looks definitely better, the quality. This one here, I'd say they're pretty much about the same. I don't see really any difference. And our mystical forest scene with giant glowing mushrooms. Same idea. I don't see a huge difference between these two. In all honesty, I think the Juggernaut 8 has a little more color to it. Now for our alligator emerging from the water. Well, this one, I definitely like the one on the right. And I think this comes down to a lot of the, well, I'm not sure. But I think the one on the right there is better. Now for our movie posters. The one on the left kind of got the idea of what I wanted with the movie poster. The one on the right really didn't. These I find can be hit or miss sometimes. I haven't fully figured those out. And our Norman Rockwell painting. Oh boy. The one on the left looks a little warmer color, where the one on the right is a little cooler color. I'm not sure which one I like better. Probably the one on the right. Although that poor baby calf is probably not comfortable. And our wizards. Oh, wizards. I'm not sure if either one is better. They both are good. They're different. I couldn't say either way. And our Danny DeVito eating a rum ham. Well, I think this one definitely 9 wins out. It's supposed to be a painting. The one on the left really doesn't look much like a painting, whereas the one on the right definitely looks like more like a painting. So I think that one pulled that off much better. And as far as the still life of assorted fruits, oh boy. I really like the Juggernaut V9 better. It's got one bottle, which is, you know, we asked for. I think the color's a little better. Now, as far as our woman eating a burger, I don't know which one's better here. I think on the one on the right, actually. It's got a little more detail. And for our dragon, I don't think either one is any better in that regard. They're both good. Very similar. And for our D&D map, for printing, see, I think both, not bad on either one. Obviously, the one on the left is brighter colors, but that just could be a, you know, random image generation difference. Hard to say one way or the other. And for our cat mafia boss, oh boy, I am not sure. I am really not sure on this one. Certain parts of the one on the right I like, and certain parts of the one on the left I like. There's more color to the one on the left, but I think overall the one on the right otherwise, hard to say. From all the images I've generated when testing, I have to say the overall version 9 gives better results with simple prompts. When you get more detailed prompts, I don't notice as much of a difference. There's no reason not to use both checkpoints if you find one does better than the other one for certain things. Now, as for the next version of Juggernaut, it seems that it'll be a complete reboot. They're going to relabel everything and do much better in that regard. But it will most likely be after they do the Stable Cascade version that's coming soon. Now, hopefully this gives you an idea about the results of each of these models. If you found this video helpful, please do consider hitting that like button. If feedback is good on this video, I'll start doing more comparison videos and also check out new models and Loras. Also, any good prompts I can use for testing, please feel free to leave them in the comments. Just make sure they're YouTube friendly and not super long. I like to stay out of trouble. But I do want to expand on some different image types for my testing. Thanks for watching and keep creating.